thank you to everyone. It has been a tremendous opportunity for me to know everyone in the Boy Scout community, you know, my troop, other scouts and other troops, knowing all people, my friends, my family, and the communities I've been a part of. I just really owe a lot to all of you and your help, and your advice, and your jokes, and all the things that push me forward. A couple specific things I wanted to give, and I have to start a little bit back. Mrs. Banks, you were the, I believe, the den, the den mother, the den leader of our den of four Weevilos. As you may have heard, I did not start a tiger. I started at Weevilo. Unfortunately, the den was chock full of scouts, and there was another spot open. But Mrs. Banks, you were there at the very beginning to excite me in scouting. And I have to say, I believe other than you, there is another scout of the four who's become an Eagle. So 2 for 4, not a bad record. Compared to the Nationals. That, yes, that deserves more applause. And furthermore, I also want to say to Justin, thank you for being, of course, a mentor outside of scouting, but of course for instilling in me a love for scouting and to be a role model, really, for me to go forward being an Eagle. Mark had just spoken how, you know, seeing 2 Eagle Scouts really inspired him to be an Eagle Scout. Well, knowing that you were an Eagle Scout inspired me. So I want to say thank you to that. And thanks also for the music. That's great too. Of course, I cannot go without thanking my parents. Mom, well, actually, there's not a whole lot to say because Mr. Sink stole most of it. Mark, as you know, every single Eagle has an imprint of his mother's foot on his back, in my case, a little lower. So you've been tremendous in helping me go forward. I also want to thank, of course, my grandparents for their support as well, for all the times, you know, being there when I was getting these achievements. But specifically, I want to thank Grandpa and John for your help with my Eagle project. If you went to one of my projects and you used a tool, it was most likely my grandfather's that I borrowed from him. And in the rare case that it wasn't, it was probably John's chisel, which was abused by being dropped on the concrete floor of our garage. So thank you so much for your help there and for helping instruct the scouts. And really, it was a wonderful thing for me. I just want to say, yes, to all the scouts, all the people who supported me, to my scoutmasters, it's been wonderful. Another thing I want to add, just I don't want to take you over too long, but when I was talking to Mr. Sinks with regard to what scout law matters a lot to me, reverence, I have to say, was a tie, another one. And I chose another two, but the other one was a scout is obedient. Now, obedience isn't the most popular thing in our highly individualistic area. I mean, we're in Silicon Valley, right? We all have the legend of the guy who started a large multinational corporation in his backyard, tinkering with a motherboard. I mean, that's just a huge idea of individual. But scouting for me really instilled a sense of what obedience means. You know, it doesn't have to be a, you know, caricature of totalitarianism of listening to your superior all the time. It's a choice we make. You know, we choose when to be obedient. And we make that choice. And I think one thing that stood out to me a lot, we always talk about in youth programs like scouting, how much leadership matters and how great it is to be a leader, and you know, don't you want that leadership experience? Sometimes it's important to realize that practically speaking, not everybody can be a leader at any given time. And so with the virtue of obedience, I'd say that it's taught me the importance of being a good follower and what that can mean. I have to say to Ryan, who over there in the audience, I was his ACL, and I learned a lot from that. It's a really, really good opportunity. And I also have to say to actually Heracles, you were the SPL that I joined the troop. And though I didn't realize it at the time, and for several years when I became an SPL, I'm like, wait a second, I'm pretty sure Mark's older brother was the one in charge. And your leadership did influence me a bit, so thank you for that. But of course, there is one person I have left out who's a tremendous influence. And so I believe my mentorship pin right here. I would like to give this to Mr. Webster for all the times that you put up with my polite emails going on for a while, and for listening to me ramble about video games years ago. Thank you so much.